Eli. There's no need to break the sound barrier.
Now, sissy.
Good to have you back, Margaret. I had no idea you'd stay in Europe for 6 months.
Well, I was doing some research for an article, and the article finally turned into a book. Or at least that's what my publishers insist.
A writer is supposed to write, right? How come I didn't get one postcard? Just for that, I have a good mind not to tell you the big news.
What big news?
Oh, I'm not going to tell you unless you coax me. Ah, I'm coaxed. Well, fasten your seatbelt. This is going to be a big surprise. Your twin sister has fallen in love.
Liz in love? You mean our career girl has finally fallen? Whoo! He must be quite a guy.
Oh, he is. He is. Mario Cellini, the latest thing in men. He's tall, dark, handsome, and rich.
Well, I never thought anyone could take Liz away from dress designing.
Well, it shows she had a few designs we didn't know about.
I'm very glad for Liz that she finally found the right man.
I'm not so sure whether he's the right man or not, but she's pretty happy. Elizabeth?
Margaret! Well, what a wonderful surprise!
Hi, sis.
You look great. But I thought you were in Spain. How did you get here?
I brought her.
At 100 miles an hour.
Well, come in, come in, sit down.
Well, why are you in San Francisco? A number of reasons. First of all, to check up on my kid sister.
For 18 minutes. She's 18 minutes older than I am, and for the rest of my life, I'm going to be her kid sister.
Well, I'm glad to see you anyway.
Well, let's celebrate. Let's make a night of it.
At this hour of the morning?
Why not? Let's go someplace.
But I've been someplace all the way from New York.
Yeah, and I've been to the airport. That's almost as far.
How about some coffee? There's some perking right now.
How would you two live wires like some coffee?
I'll have some.
Me too.
You're both so nice to me. Nobody'd ever know you were my relative.
What's the matter with her, Uncle Eli?
There's nothing matter with her. She's fine, fine, fine.
No, she isn't. She's covering up something. She's too keyed up, too gay.
Well, if a girl wants to act gay, why can't she just be gay?
Because I know her.
I know her, too. Maybe she's excited about seeing you, that's all. Or maybe it's just love.
There we are. Sugar, anyone?
Liz, I'm your sister. He's your uncle. Remember us? We don't take sugar.
Oh, I just wasn't thinking. We don't have to make a national issue out of it. Come clean, Margaret. I want to hear all about everything. What are you doing here?
Well, I thought I'd use the little cottage at Tahoe, go up there and put my book together. Tahoe?
Well, I'm sorry, Margaret, but I'm going to be using it myself. I was packing just as you came in.
Well, there's room for two.
I know, dear. But, well, I need to be alone, completely alone.
Now, Liz, that's no way to treat your older sister.
Margaret, why don't you stay here? That would do just as well, wouldn't it? And Jenny could do your cleaning and your cooking.
I suppose so.
Liz, what is this?
What is what?
No coffee.
No coffee?
No.
Oh, no coffee! No coffee.
You see? I knew it. There is something wrong.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Doesn't everybody conserve instant water?
Well,
In the third race, huh? What's his prize? Come in. Well, I tell you, put it on the nose. Yeah, that's okay. All right, so long, Joe. Come in.
How about that?
How about what?
Your Mr. Mario Cellini, the latest thing in men, is also the latest thing in rats.
Margaret, what are you talking about? And for heaven's sake, sit down. You're making divots in my carpet.
Out of the blue, your delightful Mario has given my sister the brush. Just like that.
No.
That's why she went to Tahoe this morning.
And I suppose you talked about it all night, huh?
Yes, we did. She said it was all over. Can you imagine? He had the nerve to tell her that the party was over, the merry-go-round was slowing down, and it was time for her to get off. Why, it must have been brutal.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that.
But why did he have to do it to her?
I understand he's done it to a lot of girls. He sort of makes a career of not getting caught. He doesn't want to get married. He's allergic to it. He gets the itch, but he's afraid to scratch it. Liz isn't the only girl he's ever jilted, you know.
Well, I'd like to make her the last.
Did Liz say that she was still in love with him?
Well, she acted like she was. She was in tears most of the time. Uncle Eli, a man shouldn't be allowed to get away with a thing like that. That big egomaniac, I'd like to cut him down to size. I'd like to stick a hat pin through that handsome heart of his and teach him a lesson he deserves.
Well, if you're planning to do it now, you may have a slight time problem. I believe he leaves for Acapulco in a month.
Oh. Well, then I won't have much time to build him up and then cut him down. Yes, that won't be too easy. But I'll try. Well, I've got to run.
Yeah, run? Just when we're starting to hatch the plot?
The plot has already been hatched. I have research to do.
Yeah, research?
Yes, research. And when I get through with Loverboy, he's going to be sorry he ever learned to whistle at girls.
Margaret, what are you doing here?
I'm supposed to be Elizabeth. Now, go away.
Golly, you'd fool anybody, excepting your Uncle Eli. I'd recognize that nasty disposition anywhere.
Please, he'll be here any second.
Well, all right, relax. I'm not going to give you away. I take it that he is Mr. Cellini?
Yes, and I've had the devil's own time even getting him to come here, and you're going to spoil everything. I wish you'd go away.
I'll go away the minute you see him coming. Tell me, what about the research on the fella?
I have a pile of it. Oh, he's something. He's 35, his family owns half of Italy, and he's never worked a day in his life.
But he's very good at it.
His pattern with women is always the same, but I have found his weakness.
Oh, really?
One, he doesn't like women who fall for him.
Anything else?
Two, he's extremely jealous, especially if the other man is attractive. That's all part of the picture.
There must be a three.
Three, he's particularly attracted to the outdoor type, which Liz is not.
The outdoor type? Well, I'm an electric blanket man myself.
Four, he has a mania for possessions. Rare and beautiful antiques, I mean. He makes a fetish of them.
What's that?
Bait.
Bait?
Oh, here he comes now. Beat it.
Hello, honey.
Do me a favor. Don't ever research me, will you? Happy day to day.
Thank you. Hello, Liz.
Hello, Mario.
You're looking as beautiful as ever.
Thank you. It was very nice of you to join me for lunch.
I must say, I was surprised at your phone call. You should be very angry.
I guess I read too much Noel Coward. I mean, it was fun while it lasted, but I knew it had to end. All good things come to an end.
You're a wonderful girl, Liz. And I wish you every happiness in the world.
Thank you, Mario. But I wanted it to end nicely, gracefully, the way it began. That's why I wanted to see you, so that we might say goodbye like friends.
Well, before we say goodbye, shall we have lunch? Hmm? Waiter? Liz, you didn't have to do this. It's beautiful. I've been looking for one like it for years.
I bought it months ago for your birthday. So I thought I might as well give it to you as a farewell gift.
I really don't know how to thank you. You have no idea what this means to me.
Oh, yes, I do.
Well, I must admit it was a very pleasant lunch. And I think we should follow it up with dinner tonight.
I'm sorry, but I have a previous engagement.
But Liz...
Goodbye, Mario. And lots of luck.
Hello.
Uncle Eli, can you talk?
Did you ever know me when I couldn't? Hi, Margaret. Or are you Elizabeth today?
Now, stop being funny. I only called to tell you that my little plan is working out just fine.
Margaret, let me ask you something. Are you sure you're doing all of this for Elizabeth?
What do you mean by that?
Well, he's a pretty fascinating guy, you know, and you're not beyond being hooked yourself.
Don't be ridiculous. He's not my type. Now, will you help me or not?
Of course. J. Edgar, what is your problem?
Scuttlebutt has it that Mario is going to the Skylar Johnson's party on Thursday night. Do you know them?
Yeah, I know them. So does Liz.
Well, can you get me an invitation?
Of course I can. But it's not customary for the Johnsons to invite unescorted ladies.
Unescorted? Don't worry, Uncle Eli. I don't think I'll be unescorted. It was awfully nice of you to fly here on the spur of the moment, Gardner.
I'd do anything for my favorite writer, Maggie.
Hey, shh! I'm Liz, don't forget. And don't forget, you're supposed to be fascinated with me.
I am.
Oh. Now, wait a minute, Gardner. No malarkey. This is strictly business.
Listen, Liz, I don't know what's going on. But I wish I had this plot on Adventures in Paradise.
Who's that Liz Harker dancing with?
Good heavens, Mario, where have you been? That's Gardner McKay.
That's what I was afraid of.
They make quite a striking couple together, don't they?
Yes, they do.
Mario, if you want to stop and stare at them, let's sit down.
I'm sorry, Eddie. Good evening. Are these places taken?
Yes, the Parkers.
It's quite all right.
How are you, Liz?
I'm fine, thank you. Gardner McKay, Mario Cellini.
How do you do?
And
Irene Goddard.
I'm delighted to meet you, Mr. McKay.
My pleasure. Excuse us.
Nice to see you, Irene.
Is he the one?
That's my boy. Your presence has worked magic. Mission accomplished with bells on.
I'm delighted.
Now we can go anytime you want.
I don't want to. Besides that, I always win the girl. It's in my contract.
Oh, well, I'm terribly sorry, Mario, but I'll be busy all day tomorrow. And Wednesday, too. Yes, I did say friends, and I meant just that, friends. Oh, thank you for the lovely roses. Thursday? Well, I'll be at the Sand and Sea Club all Thursday afternoon. All right, I'll see you there. Goodbye. Uncle Eli, you may be the first to congratulate me. I'm still in business.
I'll never trust a woman again. Well, what's your next move now?
To buy the prettiest bathing suit I can find.
Yeah, that'll be nice, yeah.
know you like the outdoors.
There are lots of things about me you don't know.
I can't wait to find out.
That's indoors. Aren't we having fun?
No. I'm serious. I made a mistake and I've admitted it. But I feel quite differently about you now.
Just because I gave you that little vase.
Don't be ridiculous. It's a wonderful gift, but it's not that, believe me. It's you, Liz. You are different suddenly. I can't put it into words, but you're not the same girl.
Oh?
I just had a great idea.
What?
I'm going to Acapulco tomorrow. How about coming with me?
No, I haven't the slightest intention of going to Acapulco or any place else with you.
Why not?
Many reasons. Among them, I don't want to.
I don't understand you, Liz.
But I understand you, Mario. It took a bit of doing, but I do.
Well, if you do, you know I mean it. You are coming with me. You want to bet?
I wouldn't take your money.
Will you do one thing for me?
It depends.
Come to dinner at my apartment tonight. I'm just having a few other couples.
I'm sorry. I have a date.
Break it. This is important to me. Will you do it?
I'll try.
Good. I'll pick you up at 7.
Elizabeth, I'm back.
Oh, you are? Oh, well, this is rather awkward.
Awkward? Why?
Well, you see, your sister...
Yes, what about my sister? Just as I drove up, I saw myself leaving with Mario. Where was I going?
Well, you were going... she was... you see... No, I guess you don't see.
Uncle Eli, will you drive over here as fast as you can? That is, without killing anyone. It's a lovely party, Mario.
Thank you, darling. I'm so happy you changed your mind and came. I hope I can change your mind about Acapulco.
We'll see.
I'm counting on it.
You're pretty sure of yourself, Mr. Cellini, aren't you?
Why shouldn't I be? I'm madly in love with you, and your eyes say that you love me.
You should see what they say from this side.
Well, Mario, I hope you don't mind my dropping in, the uninvited guest.
Not at all. Nice to see you, Mr. Harcourt.
To be perfectly honest with you, there is a reason. There she is.
Please come in.
Well, Uncle Eli, what a surprise.
You don't know the half of it. You see, Mario, when her father died, I promised him that I would look after her, and I've regretted it ever since.
Oh, sure, Elizabeth isn't giving you any trouble, is she?
Oh, yes, she is.
Mario, why don't you get Uncle Eli
a drink? Yes, that's a fine idea.
What will you have?
I'll have a double martini with plenty of vermouth.
You mean not dry?
No, wet. I'm an eccentric. Your little sister's here.
Elizabeth, where?
She's out in the hall waiting. She's liable to burst in here any minute. Oh, Margaret, we're in trouble.
Well, what do you want me to do?
You let her in the back door and take her into the bedroom. You know where it is? Well, see if you can find it. She wants to talk to you.
What about?
Well, never mind now.
Oh, there you are.
Thank you.
Oh, if you'll excuse me for a second, I'll be right back. Maybe.
Well, here's to confusion. Mario, have you ever been to the sports car races? Do you ever go?
No, I don't think so.
No, they're lots of fun. You should go, really. You know those little cars do 160 miles an hour?
Sounds dangerous.
Only getting into them. Oh, it's a lovely party, Mario, lovely. In fact, it's one of the nicest parties I've ever invited myself to. No, that isn't right, is it? I should say it's one of the nicest parties to which I've ever invited myself. To. Yeah, that's better.
Margaret, I'm going through with this. You're not. But Liz, Mario's going to propose to me tonight. Aren't you a little confused? He's going to propose to me. Well, if I were you, and I'm beginning to think I am, I would turn him down. Don't you think that's my decision? It's my life, isn't it? I'm not going to live it by proxy. I'm going to live it myself. All right, you win, but I hope you know what you're doing. Margaret, take off that dress. I'm going to wear it. Okay. Better unzip me.
Everything all right?
Keep out of here.
Yeah, what's going on in there? I am terribly sorry.
My wife's wrap. It's in there. A pink mink jacket. She wants her glasses.
Well, my niece, she's had one of those unspeakable catastrophes, you know, a shoulder strap.
And... Oh, I'm sorry.
Well, it's quite all right. Repairs are underway. It'll be all right in a few minutes.
I'll be back.
Yes, all right. Whatever's going on, please hurry. There's a pink mink in there with glasses. I mean, there's a man in there. Elizabeth, you've changed dresses. Well, now Mario will think you're... you.
And he'll be right.
You. Margaret, what is happening here? Now, I demand an explanation. I'm an accessory to the crime, you know.
My sister insists upon handling this thing herself.
Well, that's what started all this in the first place. Oh. Well, I'd better get those glasses for that fella. Find me a pink mink jacket in a hurry.
Why can't you find it yourself?
Because I haven't got my glasses.
That's it in your hand.
It is. Oh, that's his. Where's... Oh, I got it. Oh, thank you.
You're welcome. Uh-huh. My, what a lovely vase. Where'd you get it?
You have a charming sense of humor. Would you like to go out on the terrace?
Why not?
Margaret, he's taking her out onto the terrace.
Oh, this is the end. For all I know, Elizabeth may accept.
Oh, heavens to Betsy, no. Go in. Oh, there we are.
Thanks, very kind of you. I trust the crisis is over.
That I'm not so sure about.
Margaret.
Yes, yes.
They're out on the terrace.
Well, get out there and see what's going on.
All right.
You know, Liz, I'm going to win my bet after all.
What bet?
You're going to Acapulco with me.
I am?
Yes, darling. I have it all arranged. My car is downstairs. We are flying tonight to Acapulco. I'll get your wrap.
My wrap? Oh, don't! Wait!
Mario, wait a minute!
Oh, forget my wrap. It's only a white box.
What?
What?
It's full of moths.
You're just being a little silly, isn't it? Now that we are alone, darling.
Alone? Oh. Oh, yes, alone. Alone at last. Just the two of us.
This will come as a surprise to you. As a matter of fact, it even surprises me, darling. I want you to marry me.
Well, that's very sweet of you, Mario, but the answer is no.
Did you say no?
Yes. No. I had a month to think it over, and the merry-go-round has slowed down, and it is time to get off.
A month to think it over? I don't understand, but I won't take no for an answer. You'll change your mind in Acapulco, darling. Terribly sorry.
You must be married.
Twins? There are two of you.
There usually are.
Which one am I in love with?
Will the real Elizabeth Harcourt please stand up?
She's standing. It doesn't really matter. Neither one of us is going to Acapulco.
Oh, don't look at me. I get freckles in the sun. Well, girls, as far as we're concerned, I guess the party's over. Goodbye, Mario. It's been a pleasant evening. Say goodbye to Mario, girls.
Goodbye, Mario. Goodbye, Mario.
Come, Margaret.
Goodbye.
You sure scared me. I thought you were going to say yes. That's what I wanted you to think. I was only teaching my older sister to mind her own business. Besides, I met a charming man at Tahoe. Really? I was going up there tomorrow. What's his name?
Oh, please, let's not start that again. Well, it was a good night, everybody. Good
night. Don't be alarmed. There isn't another sister. I'm Ginger Rogers. Now that you've met the Harcourt twins, who bear a striking resemblance to me, I'd like to tell you a little about them and about the direction our series will take. In the show you have just seen, Elizabeth and Margaret both appear. But that isn't necessarily the format of our series. In most shows, only one girl will appear, and we feel this will give us a greater variety of stories. Elizabeth is a wonderful mixture of emotions, intuitions, and contradictions. And her profession, a fashion designer, permits us to tell stories of a sophisticated and romantic nature. She can go from New York to Hollywood, Paris to Rome. And, in general, will be involved in comedy situations. Margaret, on the other hand, is a little more serious. And being a writer often gets involved in dramatic stories and even mystery and suspense. Well, there you have it. Sometimes Elizabeth, sometimes Margaret, and sometimes both. But regardless of which twin appears in the show, Charlie Ruggles will be here every week, and so will I.